Jamie.
Come in through the window again, Derek?
No. Your maid said I could find you back here.
What can I do for you?
Isn't Stacy here?
No, she just left a little while ago.
Do you know where she went? Any idea?
Looking for you, I guess.
Any idea if she heard any news at all?
Oh, yes, that's when she left.
Well, okay. I'll try someplace else.
Okay.
Oh, hey. Tell your mother from me that I was really happy that she got her red swan back.
Sure. Well, she's very happy about that. Listen, I'm glad the charges against you were dropped.
Yeah?
I'm sure it must make you very happy.
Right. Thanks.
Sure. I'm sure that might make things easier, too.
Make things easier? What? I don't know what you mean.
Well, it just seemed that Stacy was a little upset about something.
Stacy was
upset? When
she
was here earlier. Yeah.
Well, but what, about me? Something I did?
I hope you know she can be hurt very easily.
Listen, I don't mean any disrespect, Doc. But after the way you treated Vicky, I don't think you should be handing out any advice. Thanks.
You having a nice time?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, I'm having a great time.
Good.
I can't believe now that I was so uptight this morning.
Well, see, that's the great thing about these trips. It gives you a chance to get away and do things you don't normally do for a change. And to be who you really want to be.
Just play. I think I need a phone. Can I have a phone, please?
Sure. Phone, please.
Thank you.
Great for
you guys. You know what?
What?
There's so many numbers to remember when you have a calling card.
Especially for you, huh?
Just kidding, just kidding.
Hello?
Hey, brother dear, how are you?
Amanda? Hi. Where the hell are you? It sounds like a war movie.
It's a cloud, that's music.
No kidding. How'd your meetings go?
Meeting? It went great. Better than I expected. I called to tell Sam about it. Can you put him on?
Well, he's not here right now.
What?
No, he went for a walk with Olivia Matthews.
Oh. Isn't it a little late for a walk?
Yeah. Well, I don't know, sis. I haven't really thought about it. Why? Is there a problem?
No. No, nothing's wrong. Just tell him I called, okay? And kiss Allie for me.
Sure, no problem. I'll see you soon, I hope.
Right. Yeah, around noon, I think. Bye.
Boy, it's hot in here.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, what do you think about going out and getting some dinner? What do you say?
I think that tonight is my night to celebrate. And I am going to celebrate. Ready?
Yeah, that's my kind of girl. Watch out now, watch out. I gotta get her while she's good. Come on.
Sometimes it seems like this world's closing in on me. There's no way of breaking free. And then I see you reach for me. Sometimes I wanna give up, wanna give in. I wanna quit the fight. And then I see you, baby.
Talk about you.
Me? What about me?
Your work. What's going to happen when you finish this series of studies?
Well, I'll get a show in the spring, I guess.
That's great.
Yeah. Well, it means a lot of work for the next couple of weeks, you know, with the holidays and everything. It's gonna be kind of tough this year.
Because of Mr. Corey?
Well, yeah. You know, Thanksgiving is always this big family soiree at the Corey's. And Mac used to sit at the head of the table and he'd give this big speech. What? What is it?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking.
Yeah? About what?
Thanksgiving. When I was a little girl, I mean, I didn't even know what it was.
Why not?
Well, we lived in Europe.
Well, you mean your dad never took you out for any kind of turkey feast or nothing like... No.
He was traveling all the time. But I remember one time, he did make us a great big dinner once. It had everything, you know, turkeys, cranberries, a little bit. God, he even made bread. Pretty heavy bread, but I loved it anyway. It was just the two of us, you know, the whole day.
That sounds nice.
Yeah. It was really the only time I can remember that I came first. We weren't supposed to talk about this anymore.
It's okay.
No, it's not. I'm sorry.
Listen, it's better to get this kind of stuff out in the open instead of bottling it up.
Just so mad at him.
I don't blame you. Look, the least the guy could have done is told his kids he was getting married again.
You know what it's like? It's like I'm this extra person in his life. I feel like I've spent my entire life trying to get him to notice me, you know? The schoolwork, the ballet.
Listen to me. When I talked to your father, he was very proud of you.
Maybe. I don't know, but... The thing that that should happen now, that I'm supposed to be growing up, is that I should be able to accept this, and I can't. Now that he's married, he's never gonna come back.
You'll see him again. You will.
I don't understand why this still hurts so much. He's never been there for me, you know, all my life. I don't understand why it hasn't still hurt like this.